Rhonda McBride joins us now with a preview of tonight's Closer Look. Rhonda?
Mike and Maria, it's a construction project making telecommunications history. Tonight, a closer look at GCI's Project Terra, which is bringing high-speed internet to a large chunk of Bush, Alaska. If you live in Anchorage or another urban area with high-speed internet, think back to the days when you got on the internet with a dial-up modem. Remember what that was like? Well, now you can empathize with rural Alaskans who have been struggling with a slow and cumbersome satellite system. But thanks to GCI's Project Terra Southwest, a closer look at how all that is about to change.
This is the largest project that GCI has done to date. This is very much like fielding an army. It's all about logistics.
Jimmy Sipes is GCI's chief engineer, and in his 29 years with the company, this project is his most challenging, especially when it comes to timing, critical for putting materials on barges.
We had to catch the rivers at high water during the spring runoff in order to get the cranes in that were needed. And we had to catch the mountaintops just as the snow melt off because we have a very short construction season.
This ballet between the helicopter and crew is definitely dangerous and daring. So many moving pieces in this project, where the work is literally all over the map. Part of Project Terra began last winter near Leavelock with cable installed underground. Then this summer, crews began laying cable in Homer, where they extended it across Cook Inlet to Williamsport in the Lake Iliamna area. The cable was also dropped into Lake Iliamna, one of Alaska's deepest lakes, its underwater contours never before surveyed until Project Terra.
Should you get a break of that cable during winter months, you will not be able to recover the cable to repair it until the ice goes out.
GCI wound up installing two underwater cables, so there's a backup.
This piece runs about $5 million.
Redundancy. It comes with a huge price tag and a lot of extra effort. Effort that is required in almost every aspect of this endeavor.
It's the most complicated permitting job we've ever had, ever dealt with. It turned out to be more complicated than we imagined.
Complications like installing microwave repeaters on mountaintops in the Togiak National Wildlife Refuge. In all, Project Terra Southwest needed more than 120 permits. So, will it be worth it?
I think anything you touch, really, is going to be enhanced.
Jason Matrokin is head of the Bristol Bay Native Corporation. On a daily basis from his Anchorage office, he struggles with the limits of telephone and internet service in western Alaska.
As a former banker, I know that there are challenges with rural banking, for example. I think that enhanced telecommunications will help with that. Folks out in our region in Bristol Bay are going to start to see some of the opportunities where their livelihoods will be changed for the better.
It's a challenge for a small business in rural Alaska to compete, to even put a website up. This is going to change that.
Martin Carey spent the early years of his career in Barrow, helping to build the information highway for the North Slope Borough and the school district. With a satellite-based system, it was a pretty bumpy road.
A satellite is 22,000 miles above the Earth at the equator. So your electronic bit is having to go 22,000 miles up and 22,000 miles down. That takes a quarter of a second each way. And so that's what creates the delay. And computer applications don't work well in that environment. They're expecting to get instant acknowledgments back.
Go ahead and click the button, Julian.
Instant acknowledgments needed to use new computer applications for telemedicine, as well as the exchange of digital patient records, which are too fat to move via satellite.
You see that? That's what you're in your mouth.
But the new information highway, built with a combination of microwave relays and fiber optic cable, connects to Anchorage in the lower 48 and to the technological revolution that is driving today's economy. These new microwave towers are the equivalent of off-ramps for the superhighway that will bring the world to this isolated community and its schools.
They will get better interactivity.
About 9,000 households will be served, a population too small to generate the revenue to pay for a system like this. But thanks to the federal stimulus program, GCI received $88 million in grants and loans. So far, this project has created more than 120 jobs. But more than that, a pipeline to future jobs. And when it's all done, those involved say they will feel
elated, relieved, very proud.
Proud to connect 65 communities to a world of opportunity. Now, this project actually has two parts. The first phase connects the communities, and that should be finished by the end of the year. And then during the next phase, GCI will install equipment in communities so that businesses and homes can get on the fast lane as far as the internet goes.
Huge.
And make a big difference, too.
Okay. Thanks, Rhonda.